Hello everyone, this is your teacher, Mr. Ricardo. And for you boys, we have a different lesson, a lesson that is divided into two different parts. First of all, the first part is about caring and how we can help to care about our environment. How can we help to sustainable development? How can we help to keep the environment safe? And how can we help about making the world a better place? That's the first part. The second part of what we're going to see today, we're moving into the natural resources now, specifically the agricultural resources. And we're going to learn and discuss few of the natural resources that we know in terms of agriculture. And also, we're going to discuss about the things that are made about with the agricultural resources. So that's the beginning for today. Let's move on to the glossary.
Bueno, chicos, para el glosario del día de hoy tenemos primero que nada los environmental conflicts, que son los conflictos ambientales, usualmente las situaciones estas donde un recurso está siendo extraído, está siendo explotado, pero tiene consecuencias negativas en el medio ambiente. Después tenemos sustainable development, que es el desarrollo sustentable. Esto específicamente se refiere a nuestros recursos naturales y cómo nuestros recursos naturales pueden ser constantemente renovados. O sea, esto tenemos que asociarlo inmediatamente a lo que nosotros conocemos como recursos renovables, tratar de que nuestros recursos se mantengan renovables o mantenibles dentro del tiempo. Luego tenemos los fog catchers, que tiene que ver con los atrapanieblas, lo cual lo vamos a ir descubriendo más adelante en la clase. Legumes, que son las legumbres. Grains, los granos. Y daily life, que tiene que ver con nuestra vida cotidiana. Now, it is important to understand that every human activity in the nature has some consequences. O sea, tiene consecuencias. Now, what can happen if we intervene too much? If we perform, extract, and transform the natural resources that sometimes can have negative effects. As it says here, extracting and transforming natural resources sometimes has negative effects in the environment. O sea, puede tener efectos negativos en la naturaleza. And these produce environmental conflicts. Esta es la palabra clave, environmental conflicts, as we saw before. And it can have problems like pollution, for example, other problems like deforestation. It happens when you cut too many trees in one place, let's say on a forest. It can also have problems with contamination, especially for big companies sometimes contaminate lakes, natural reserves, etc. And this also can happen in the ocean. And these things are extremely dangerous to some animals, especially, for example, the tortoise. All right. So let's continue and see what happens if I want to take care of the nature. Now, at the same time, there is people who is working to maximize and care for the natural resources and ensure its sustainability, which means that there is people helping out to create a place or to maximize the natural resources we have, to keep, to take care. O sea, va a haber gente que va a cuidar nuestros recursos naturales. For example, we have these places in which we can use the wind energy so we can create electricity, etc. And other people also work with what we have over here, especially on buildings, so we can have green areas that help to clean the air. Now, the question for this part of the lesson is, how can we contribute to sustainable development? O sea, ¿cómo podemos contribuir a este desarrollo sustentable, en cuidar, to care about our natural resources? There are a few ways to do it. If you look in the book in page 98, you're going to see these three very relatable R's. The first R is about reducing, to reduce the amount of waste of things that you produce, which is one way to help the environment. You can also try reusing, to use again something that you already use, maybe using it in the same way, o sea, usarlo de la misma forma, or sometimes you can give some things a different use, o sea, le damos un uso distinto. Also, recycling, finally, which is enables materials you throw away to be used again. O sea, utilizamos nuevamente nuestros materiales. We saw this the last lesson, and these are the three mighty R's, all right? So, I'm going to show you one of the ways that people reuse some of the natural resources that we have in Chile, especially. This happens in the far north, next to the Camanchaca. So pay attention now. So the example that we have for you are the fog catchers, which in other words are the atrapa nieblas, right? And these people, is first of all, the name is exactly what you think. They catch the fog, all right? The Camanchaca's water drops are catch by the net with a small 1 millimeter opening. So before this all mumbo jumbo, what you need to know is that all the water is catch, or most of the water is catch, by these nets. There is a lot of water between these nets, and they accumulate on the net, and then they are dropped, o sea, son botadas, into a near canal close to the net. From there, the water is brought, o sea, se lleva, through a series of pipe containers and is ready to use. The idea, as you can see over here, these are some of the nets that are able to catch the fogs. As you see, they are very big. And these are some of the containers where the water is brought. Then this water can be used by many trucks that give water to the community, especially in places where people do not have water, let's say, close into their kitchens or bathrooms, right? I'm going to show you a short video about the process of fog catchers now. So let's see it. As we discussed, as you can see over here, these are the fog catchers, and these are the nets that are able to catch the water. Over here, these are the pipes. The pipes are able to bring the water to one place to another. And as you can see over here, these are put in the coastal mountains, so they can catch, o sea, pueden atrapar, they can catch the water from the Camanchaca. As we're going to see later, I'm not so sure if the video is in that part yet, we're going to see the containers in which the water is brought. As you can see, those are the places where the water can be brought, and over there, the water is brought from the Camanchaca. So, let's continue with the class. So, to finish this part of the lesson, what we need to remember is that usually the natural resources can be used in many different ways so we can have a sustainable development of our own resources. We can do things like doing with the three R's, reducing, recycle, or reusing as well. And also we can do things like the people do in the far north about the fog catchers, all right? These two things are ways in which can we use again, and we can improve our quality of life, and we can help the environment, which is another thing that we should always take care into consideration. Now, we're moving to the next part, which is about the agricultural resources. I want you to focus on two things now. How the agricultural resources are very helpful for us, for people especially, and why they are so important. Why should we always keep them renewable, not non-renewable? How it would impact, o sea, como impactaría, how would it would impact our lives? So, that's it. Let's move to the next part. So for our agricultural resources, the first thing we should know is that the agriculture can be many things, but we're going to focus on two things now. Agriculture is a combination of techniques and knowledge to cultivate the earth. O sea, como nuestro conjunto de técnicas y conocimiento lo ocupamos para sacar provecho de la tierra. And the economic activity to obtain agricultural resources. It's also economic activity, all right? And the agricultural resources, for example, that we have in Chile, there are many. So, for example, the first one that we have over here are the grains, which are used for many different things in our country. We also have the 4-H crops, which are crops that are used to animals, to livestock production, that so also they can eat at farms, etc. They also, the things that we have, of course, they are vegetables, which we eat on our daily lives. Same goes for fruits, which are very healthy. And finally, we also have the industrial crops, which are crops that are, these crops are used some to produce some food. So for example, let's say bread, but also sometimes they are not used for someone to eat, all right? So these are some of the agricultural resources, examples of agricultural resources in Chile. Let's move on to the next part. Now for this part, we're going to explore the letters A, B, C, D, and E. We're going to focus on their explanations. Look, letter A, it is about the annual crops. We are crops that we have only one time of the year. They live for only one season, that's the thing. And they include two grains, o sea, granos, legumes, which are legumbres, for example, the porotos or beans, as you may call it, or lentejas, all right? And these seeds are eaten, which is also very important to make a distinction. Why? Because in letter B, so we have right here, letter B, it's about the industrial crops. They also grow one time a year, so annual basis, but these species must pass through an industrial process for consumption. O sea, tienen que pasar a través de un procesamiento de industrial o a través de máquinas para poder ser consumidas. And sometimes they are not only focused on things that can be eaten. They also can be for things that are non-food products. So other seeds or other products that are not used for human consumption. Then we have the climate diversity of Chile, and this produces many fruit varieties. The fact that we have many different fruits in Chile is because our very diverse climate. Letter D, produces grown orchards and includes vegetable and green legumes and some root vegetables. And finally, letter E, which I'm very interested on, is the vineyards, which are used to create wine. Esa copita de vino que tanto le gusta quizá al papá o la mamá is thanks to the vineyards, all right? So, let's continue with the products that can be made thanks to the agricultural resources. Now, the first question that we have for this part of the lesson was, how important are the agricultural resources in our daily life? So how important are they? Because they produce many derived products. For example, we have over here the grains, wheat, corn, etc. Other products that thanks to the agricultural resources are done are the tea and their different varieties that we have for tea. Many of your parents, brothers, sisters like to drink different types of tea. We have, of course, thanks to the diverse climate, we have a very diverse types of fruit in Chile. We also can have things like rice. Through industrial process, we can have things like rice. Then we have other things that can be done thanks to the industrial process, like, for example, the crisp or potato chips. If you live in England or if you live in the United States, you call it different. And of course, some people love wine. So these are thanks to the grapes and the vineyards. Finally, we can have also thanks to the industrial process, things like bread. And I mean, we all love bread, right? Bread with butter or bread with avocados, etc.
Entonces, para cerrar la clase, chicos, pequeñas cosas que recordar sobre la clase del día de hoy. Primero que nada, la primera parte tenía que ver con el desarrollo sustentable de nuestros recursos naturales. ¿Qué podemos hacer nosotros para ayudar a mantener este recurso sustentable o este desarrollo sustentable de nuestros propios recursos naturales? Por ejemplo, las 3 R, muy importante, reducir, reutilizar y reciclar. También iniciativas que vienen de la gente de un lugar en específico, por ejemplo, la que se da en lugares como el norte de Chile con los atrapanieblas que logran utilizar la niebla como un conductor para poder obtener agua. En el caso de la segunda parte, bien atentos, ya que hablamos sobre los recursos agrícolas, cómo estos tienen importancia en nuestra vida cotidiana, in our daily life, y también los productos que pueden venir de estos diferentes recursos. Así que tenerlo también bien en cuenta y por qué es importante de que estos recursos agrícolas se mantengan como un recurso renovable. Porque, bueno, me imagino que ninguno de ustedes va a querer vivir en un mundo sin papas fritas. O mucho menos sin un pancito, con palta, etcétera, etcétera. Entonces, para eso es importante cuidar nuestros recursos naturales. Chicos, esta sería la clase del día de hoy. Un abrazo grande para todos. Que tengan un excelente fin de semana largo. No se porten tan mal, ocupen harta mascarilla y nos vemos.